Anderson Cooper, AC360, CNN Weeknights 10 Eastern.
How is it possible that you only found out and the principals only found out about the bullying 1 week before she killed herself? It sounds almost impossible to believe if the DA is correct and this has been going on for 3 months and involved more than half a dozen kids.
Well, it did not involve, apparently it did not involve more than half a dozen kids because those are the kids who are being arraigned for carrying out the bullying. That's the same finding that we made in our investigation a month earlier. How is it possible? I deeply regret the fact that no one came forward to us and reported that this bullying was taking place. The principal does not take these matters lightly, and he would act swiftly and fully using all his powers if he knew about these events.
But I mean, on the day she died, she was, according to DA, being harassed in the school library during lunch, and it was witnessed by a teacher who didn't alert the school until after her death. So if six kids feel fine about tormenting a girl out in the open in the school library and in the hallway and throwing cans at her head on the way home from school, that seems to indicate, you know, that this wasn't the first time this had happened. I mean, how can this be going on in the hallways and nobody seemed to have reported
it? Well, first of all, if it had happened earlier, which we believe probably it did, and it had been observed by our staff and reported to us, I'm telling you that the principal would have taken stern action with the kids.
Well, the teacher apparently in the library didn't report it until after this girl was dead, on the day she died.
Okay, what? No, that's not true. What the district attorney's report says is there was a teacher present in the library when the kids were having their conversation. But the library is one of the biggest spaces in our entire school. There was a teacher present, but she was on the other side of the library, and she did not hear what the kids were talking about at their table. What the kids were talking about at the table, I'm sure they would not have wanted to talk about in front of any adult in the school. So I'm sure they we know that there were kids sitting a couple of tables away who didn't even hear what they were saying. But we did learn about what they said from the students directly and from students at that table after our investigation, which took place after the death of Phoebe.
You told the Boston Globe today that, and you said, quote, people have assumed the bullying caused her death, but we don't know why she took her own life. We think there were probably a number of possible causes. What else do you think caused her death?
Well, I would like to be able to discuss that with you, but we have been very clear from the beginning that we are not going to talk about Phoebe and her, anything that was going on in her life. But there are other possible causes. We don't know now if there was a suicide note that said why she took her life, if there was a journal that she wrote in that described what she was going through. Then the district attorney would have seen those things and probably would come to the conclusion that that she took her life totally because of the bullying. It doesn't matter. The statement doesn't matter because that doesn't justify the bullying. And we know the bullying took place, and we took very stern action as a result of that bullying.
But your critics, and you have a lot of critics now in the school district who said that the principal and the school didn't do enough to help this girl. Your critics are saying that, look, a lot of what you're saying, it all is to deflect, according to them, responsibility from the school administrators. You said, you know, early on, well, look, this was just cyberbullying, and that you only learned about it a week before she killed herself, and that, you know, it only involved the six students who have been charged, even though you've now disciplined other students who apparently were not part of this six.
Again, the conclusions that we drew from our investigation are a public record.
But your investigation was a school principal who's directly at fault for this, investigating his own actions or lack of actions. Does that seem like a proper investigation to you? Isn't the district attorney's investigation probably?
You're not letting me finish. Huh? Well, I'm sure it is, but the people in our community were pressing us very early from the day after Phoebe died to come up with some sort of explanation. And that's why the principal said he would investigate these charges. By the way, what you just said isn't fair to our principal. Okay, this principal has been in place for 10 years in that school system. He is highly revered by the community, and he's one of the finest principals that I've ever met. If he were going to do the investigation, I would trust that he would do it properly and honestly. He did not have anything to hide. Because as soon as he heard about the bullying, which for the first time was on January 7th, he acted swiftly within the same day He disciplined the students who were involved according to our code of conduct, okay? And he effectively put an end to the bullying by one group of students that was involved. He didn't take this lightly at all. When his investigation revealed that there was a second group of students that we didn't know about that was bullying also, he took the most firm action that he can take. He recommended that these students be expelled. And that is the strongest possible action he could take.